Hi and welcome to this session around our new innovative solution called MIXIT. My name is Pascal and I'm a part of the project working on MIXIT. So what do we see in front of us? What we actually see is a new kind or new way to build a mixing loop, in fact. So normally a mixing loop would comprise of 8 to 12 different components. That could be control valves, throttling valves, differential pressure control valves across that, those as well. There would be sensors, there would be a controller, there would be an actuator on top of the control valve. All of those components and complexity are actually merged into these two solutions. So we have the mixing unit, which is the controller and controls the primary side that is connected wirelessly to the pump. In this case, it's a magnet-free pump, but it could also be a TP-free pump. These two were acted as in the entire mixing loop. How MIXIT operates? I have brought a real version of MIXIT here, or at least a physical variant of MIXIT here. So what we see here is the MIXIT interface. If I turn it around, that would be the side you can't see from the camera, behind the camera. But here, behind these snugly fit insulation shells, we have a valve, and it looks like a freeway valve. But in fact, it operates both as a two or a three valve, dependent whether it rotates to the right or to the left. This would be the supply side on the primary side. Here we have a temperature and flow sensor placed. The return temperature we measure in the bypass. So there's a temperature sensor here, along with a non-return valve that is easily changeable. The temperature from the flow side, so the mixed temperatures, comes from the pump. The data is shared wirelessly, therefore we have all the temperatures, we have the flow as well, and having the temperature on the primary side and the flow also give us power and energy. So actually there's no need for an energy meter unless you have a need for billing. So this is, we can say, some of the technical part, and the beauty of MIXIT is not only reduces complexity in the amount of components and design and installation and all that stuff, but also in depending on which type of building it is. So, and furthermore, actually, it acts as a two and three valve. I already said that, but actually it also works for heating and cooling. So it's still the same solution. And furthermore, control-wise, it can operate as a standalone solution. So basically you can set a specific temperature and then it will obtain it. You can also connect an outdoor temperature sensor and set up a heat curve through Grundfos building, Grundfos Go Remote. So there's Bluetooth connectivity in this guy, and then you can connect through the Grundfos app and set up the weather curve and that stuff. And there you can run solitary down in the basement. If you have a need or have a desire to connect your devices, MIXIT there is a free monitoring solution included on Grundfos Building Connect. So down here we have an Ethernet port. If you connect that one connect it to the internet and follow a very user-friendly wizard on Go Remote that will eventually give you a number for your specific mixing unit, then you can go on to Building Connect, enter the number, and then you can claim your mixing device and create a location and put it into a map. And there you can monitor it for free. If you then want to have remote control, trend data, analytics, insightful alarms, user management, and a ton of other stuff, you can upgrade from the free user to a professional license that gives you the functionality. In larger building, where we have a building management system, there is a need for field bus. So luckily, MIXIT is also embedded with field bus. It is not unlocked from factory, but it is within. So I will just like this. So if you want to unlock the functionality, it's basically just to purchase an activation code from Grundfos. Use Grundfos Go Remote to connect to the device, tap in the number, and unlock the functionality on the device, on the mixing unit. There's no need to put on an external gateway or change the entire unit to a new one. It is the same unit. So it's, as we think of Tesla, we have the radar, the proximity sensors, we have the cams, but it doesn't drive itself unless you have the software to do so. So that's the same we do with MIXIT, a common hardware platform, and depending on your needs, we can offer different functionality, but it's the same product. Your need might be a standalone solution from day one, but in 2 years you might want to have the BMS connectivity, and then it's the same product. You just purchase an upgrade code and then it's available. So standalone, connected to our cloud and into to larger buildings through field bus. So therefore you could also ask, what is the performance range? If loosely said, we have a performance range from 300 liters an hour all the way up to 30,000 liters an hour. And if you put a delta T on top of that, it's somewhere from 10 kilowatt all the way up to 800 kilowatt. So a pretty broad range, and that is obviously within heating with that delta T, but basically again, it can be used both for heating and for cooling. I already mentioned something about Grundfos Go Remote. We don't have a big screen placed on Mixit. On Mixit, you see the most, you can say, interesting stuff that you need once you go down to the plant room and then look at it. So what we have here is the temperature. The temperature shown here is the actual temperature on the flow side. If I press one time, I can see what is the actual set point it's trying to obtain. That can be from outdoor sensor, it can be from BMS. Normally we never know what the set point from the BMS are unless we have access to the BMS system. If I press it again, then I have a blue, this is set up for heating, a red one, so this is set up for heating, so that is illustrating the temperature on the supply side, and again, the return temperature indicated by a blue arrow. Once you do if you want to do a commission, you do use Grundfos Go Remote, and Go Remote has a wizard. You can say it's like setting up your printer. You will be asked, is it this, is it for heating, is it for radiator, the set point source, is it that outdoor field bus, and all of that stuff. You will ask all the right questions in the right order for Grundfos Go Remote, so that's easy to commission. Furthermore, since we have a flow sensor within Mixit, balancing Mixit is dead easy. Normally, if you want to do flow balancing, you will need a measuring gauge, measure across a throttling valve or balancing valve, measure the DP, get an app, find out the size of the valve and the flow, and then it will say the handle should be set at 5, for example. With Mixit, since we have a flow sensor, it's dead easy. You just say to Mixit, you should not let in more water than 2 cubic meters an hour, and that is commissioning done. Furthermore, since we also have power, you can also, if you know what the heat loss is on the secondary side, you can say to Mixit, you should not let in more heat in than 80 kilowatt hours, or more cooling in that the coil actually can obtain. So to summarize Mixit, it is 2 components instead of 8 to 12 components. That means it's 50% faster to install. Insulation-wise, there are 2 insulation shells. There is no insulation around thermometers, capillary tubing going across these pipes and valves and whatnot. Wiring is already done, that the unit is factory tested. And when it comes to field bus integration, this acts as a controller, so basically it replaces the PLC you would probably need if you have a building management system. So installation-wise, it is way more cost-efficient to install Mixit. And then you could figure out what would the price be of such a solution. And in fact, we actually tried to positioning more or less on the same price band as the traditional components would be. So if you look at the total cost, Mixit would be a more cost-efficient solution compared to a traditional solution. Not even taking into consideration faster to design, faster to implement the design, less risk of commissioning errors, installation errors. If there is malfunction, you probably all know that is that the plumber or the mechanical guy, is the electrical guy or the integrator. Basically, since we provide the entire solution, there is only one to call, and it would be us to help you. So the benefits are endless. Maybe one last benefit would be that this solution here works. It is a digital solution, you would say. We have sensor input, and then we have algorithms. Normally, wise, you would maybe have membranes or spring to do pressure dependency and stuff like that. But we measure power, temperatures, flows on the primary side, and also for the pump control mode, all of that. All these data points can be collected either through our cloud on Building Connect or through the building management system. So we provide more than 100 data points coming from the Mixit and the pump through a single field bus or a single connectivity gate endpoint, let's call it that. So all these data flows into the building management system. Then you can say take action on them. Okay, I would like to do something. On normal circumstances, you would need to go out on site and actually turn a knob or press on the pump or something. But with Mixit, you have control of both devices through the field bus or through our cloud. So if you want to do actions, you can just set the limiters. So if I set the limiter to 2 cubic meters an hour and I want you to change it to 1.7 or whatever, then I can do it through the field bus. There's no need to be on site. So looking ahead, we probably all know that this optimization, all the devices are A+, A+, but when they act as a holistic system, they are B-. So if we want to improve that, that is how the systems are interlinked and operated in sequence with each other. And the foundation for that is that you have a good data foundation, data is king, but also that you have control to implement the action on the devices. You might have the data, but then somebody needs to go around and turn the different adjustments. Here you can do it real time. So with MIXIT, we have a future-proof solution. Ton of data, ton of control. That maybe summarizes this MIXIT very well. So heat and cooling, 2 or 3 rail, standalone connectivity-wise, ready for AI. We have really tried our utmost to build a solution that is, there's nothing like MIXIT in the market today, but really to capture all the essence of this and try to bring the value to the customer, whether it be operational cost optimization, installation-wise, commissioning-wise, design-wise. We really hope that you can see the benefits of it. Thank you very much for staying with me. I know it's a lot to take in, and therefore I really urge you, if you have any questions or want to know more about MIXIT, then please contact your local Grundfos representative, and then they can tell you more about MIXIT.